What up guys, this is the TheSighBored here. I know it's been a long time since I last did a motovlog. Well, it looks like it might be about to rain, so I guess it's a good time to get a quick motovlog going. So for today's motovlog topic, like I said, I know it's been quite a long time since I did it. You know, when you are busy, sometimes you don't really have a time for doing stuff like this. So let's get straight to it. Before we begin, light just turned green. So yeah, ironically, this is what I'm about to talk about. Well, yeah, few raindrops are starting. And oh shit, it's raining. So it's a fucking awesome time to be doing my monovlog then, since I always do it in the rain. And like I said, what I wanted to talk about, ironically, is about the traffic light, the red light. Okay, so before we begin, oh man, I just introduce myself to the rain, I guess, literally. So as I was saying, what's going on about the traffic light, or more importantly, the red light, is that before we begin, I want to stress out that it's absolutely wrong, illegal to run the red light. So in this video, we are not at all condoning the act of running the red light, because like I said, it's against the law, it's dangerous, it's illegal. However, being human, we all are human, right? So being human, I'm pretty sure that you guys, including myself, we have all done this before in one time or another, maybe a long time ago, maybe recently, you never know. So what have we done? We have ran the red light before, right? I mean, be honest guys, if you ran the red light before, just admit it. I'll admit I have ran red lights before. I'm not proud of it, but yeah. And I literally just ran a red light behind us a few minutes back. And the reason is because it's raining and I don't want to be sitting in the rain, getting soaking wet while talking to you guys, getting my spender basah. So what is it about running the red light? Like I said just now, it's illegal to do. So definitely I'm not supporting the act of doing it. But again, being human, I'm pretty sure that we all at any point of time have done something like this before. So what we want to talk about today is going to be about the safe way and the dangerous way of running the red light. Okay, so yeah, for myself, I've seen people running the red light, especially motorcyclists. Cars, not that much, but you do have cars that do it. And it's more dangerous if it's a car doing it, because the car is a larger vehicle. So and the pickup is not so great, like a kapchai, he can just zip through the intersection pretty quickly. So again, I'm not saying it's okay for motorcycles to do it, it's not okay for cars to do it, nothing like that. And also, what I'm trying to say is that I have seen people doing it very dangerously, motorcyclists doing it dangerously. And these guys are, more often than not, it's not 100%, but more often than not, they are the guys that are doing the delivery runs. Either they are sending packages, they are sending your nasi lemak bungkus, your teh ice bungkus, you know what I mean, the grab food guys, or maybe your McChicken or something like that, those food delivery guys. So more often than not, these are the guys that are actually risking their lives by jumping the light. And to be honest, you don't really save a huge, a holy lot amount of time. Okay, you just maybe save a few minutes in total of your travel time, just a few. So is it worth to do it? Well, it depends on the situation. Like I said, for my case just now, it was a quite heavy rain at that section, and I didn't really wanna sit in the heavy rain. I know you guys will enjoy it, but I would not enjoy it, having my balls soaking wet. So I decided to run the red light, but do it in a safe way. So what do I mean by doing it in a safe way and a dangerous way? Safeway to me, whenever I want to feel like running the lights, what I'll do is I will definitely slow down or stop at the light first, okay? And I will look around, I will observe all directions, I will observe which direction has the right of way, is there any oncoming vehicles. And normally if I run a red light, it's basically just to go straight. That means I'm not going to cross over to any other, like I need to make a turn off to the right and cut across the intersection, the junction. Never like that. What I'll do is, okay, so I guess I skipped a bit of rain, but more rain is inbound. So, oh well, karma, I guess. Karma for running the light, maybe. As I was saying, if I want to do some lane splitting, blah. If I want to do some runs of the running the lights, I will normally do it if it's not going to be crisscrossing any intersections. Like just now, it's a T junction, and I just wanted to go straight through, not make a right turn. I need to cut over to the other side or something like that. So I'm just going straight through, and there's no traffic that I will run head onto, or I need to cross any other traffic's path. So to me, I feel that is more on the safer side of things, because it's easy to see if there's any vehicles in your way or gonna approach incoming. So the other thing is also gonna be that you're not cutting over anybody's path. Like I'm not crossing the opposite lane's traffic path. So to me, I feel that that is a safer way for running the light if I needed to. Okay, like I said again, we are not here to talk about saying that we don't need to stop for traffic lights, we are the gods of the traffic, we don't need to stop, everyone else needs to stop. No. Okay, personally, whenever I do it cautiously, very, very cautiously. I've seen other motorcyclists that do it, especially like I said, those delivery guys, and they seem to not be so concerned at all, which quite amazes me. Yeah, because I've seen them, and I even have a near experience where I'm having the green light, I'm supposed to go straight, and this guy is on the 3 o'clock direction and he wants to go to the 9 o'clock direction. That means he's cutting through my path. This guy was playing on the phone, yeah, while riding his motorcycle. It was my way to go green, and I was about to go, and he just zipped past without even any concern, and he wasn't even aware that it was my right of way, and we could almost hit each other. For me, I got quite pissed off. Of course, I did ref bomb the shit out of him, but I don't think he gave a crap anyway. So my point is that when you do it like this, it's dangerous because you are cutting in front of the opposite lane or your incoming traffic, the path. Okay. Some of you are going to say that, ah, it's okay, man. I saw them. They are approaching the junction. It's their way of the right of way. It's their green. But I'm quite fast, and they are quite far away, so I can just easily cross, cut over their path, and cross and be gone. Yeah, I guess if you want to make that kind of argument, that's fine. But what I want to say is that I'm pretty sure most of you that ride, you drive, right? You guys drive as well. So I'm pretty sure that if you are driving, you see the light is green, you're just keeping your speed, and as you approach the junction, suddenly a bike just zooms past. It's still quite far away, it's not like right in front of you, but still you will get disrupted. You will have some sort of reaction for sure. I bet you will have some sort of reaction, because I do. Even though I ride and I expect people to do like this, but I still have a reaction. And your reaction is to suddenly slow down because you are worried that there might be more than one champion motorcyclist. Haha! This time we have champion motorcyclists, not just the cars that are champions now. So you have, I worry that there might be more than one guy that's trying to be a genius and doing that, and then I have to slow down. Although it's green, and it's my right of way anyway. But I slow down, why? Because I don't want to get into an accident and waste my time, you know, beside the roadside, discussing the fault or needing to go to the police station to make your police reports, all the good stuff like that. So that's why I slow down. So that is my own initiative, I guess, of slowing down, because I don't want to waste my time unnecessarily. But some guys, some other drivers, they might not care, they might not think twice. They say green means go, I'm gonna gas it full throttle maximum, okay? So those guys, whenever you cut in front of them, I don't think they will have enough reaction time to actually slow down or avoid you. So they're gonna like probably T-bone the shit out of you. Being the motorcyclist, you are gonna end up hurting. And do you think that's it's worth your while just to cut that couple of minutes waiting on the traffic light? So that's actually the point that I'm trying to push forward here, is to not say that you cannot cut lights. Obviously it's wrong, but being human, we do it sometimes. But there is always the safe way and the dangerous way of doing things. So I'm not saying that the safe way means you're 100% safe, there's not going to be any chance of accidents or whatever, but it's the safer way to do it, right? Your risk is lower, you're not so high risk, because at the end of the day, you guys need to know that we as the motorcyclists, the guy on two wheels, the girl on two wheels, we are the one that stand to lose the most. Let me just check if I'm holding up traffic, talking shit while going through the lovely traffic. I'm sort of soaked, but luckily this stretch is haven't started raining, I think. Haven't started raining. Yeah, so what do you guys think of this topic? Running the lights. Okay, like I said, it's wrong to do, but being human, sometimes you do it. So if you do it, how do you do it? Do you think these guys that I talk about, especially the delivery guys, and it's not just the delivery guys, because like I said, they are just the majority, and they do it because they need to be in a hurry or something. Okay, but to me, I just feel that it's, how can it be worth it? How can it be possibly worth it? Trying to risk your life over somebody's Hawaiian pizza? That's fucking crazy, man. You're gonna be a couple of minutes late, you're gonna be a couple of minutes late. You know, sometimes in dangerous conditions also, they see the car coming, or they just take a chance. It's like, oh, this car will slow down for me, and they just cut the light anyway, jump the red light anyway. So it's a very common thing that happens here in Malaysia for you guys that are overseas. It's a very common occurrence here in Malaysia for them to jump the lights. And if you're saying that, aren't they worried about police enforcement and all that? Well, the police are not at every traffic light junction, and they're not there all the time. Even if you have CCTV, I'm not sure the operator that's manning it has the time to actually catch everyone all day long, because it happens just too frequently. So this is just me giving my observations and giving out the message to you guys that are doing this, jumping the lights. There's no way to stop you from doing it. You're going to do it anyway, but maybe do it safer. Do it in a more responsible way, because although you might get hurt, okay, let's say you get into a collision, you get hurt more, you're also, in a way, you are giving trouble to other people. Like for example, if I'm the one doing the driving, I'm the driver, okay, I'm not on the bike, I'm the driver, and you do some shit like this, and we get into collision, so you are basically wasting my time as well. Okay, I didn't do any fault, you're the one that's doing the fault, being wrong, jumping the light, but you give inconvenience to others. And not only that, you're going to cause a traffic jam, because this is Malaysia. We got the nosiest mother F. We have the nosiest mother F people around here. No matter which direction, as long as there's an accident, there's always nosy mother Fs that will want to slow down, they'll want to see what's going on, check it out. So you will cause inconvenience to the person that has the collision to you. They're going to cause traffic congestion, make everything just bad, just because you wanted to save 1.5 minutes, 2 minutes of the waiting at the light. So if you want to do it, make sure you do it safe, and then you can get on your merry way. Some of you guys, I know you are fucking legend, you're fucking pro guys that do it so often every day. You are like the rempit lah, memang kau rempit lah, right? I know, but as the saying goes, no matter how good you are, obviously there will be a chance, there will be a time where you're gonna fuck up. Okay, so just be safe about it. And if you guys got any comments, opinions about this topic, just go ahead, feel free to share as I make my way, get off the LDP. So guys, I hope you enjoyed the motovlog. I know it's been a long time since I did it. Maybe I will kick it up a notch, find some topics, maybe you can share some topics to chat about, motorcycle or riding rider related topics. So as usual, till the next one guys, this has been the SighBored here. I'll see you on the next one. Till then, ride safe and safe ride.